And with me also is Daryl Johnson. Daryl is the owner of DT Analytics and is the author of two books. The first, Hate Land, a long, hard look at America's extremist heart. And the second, Right-Wing Resurgence, how a domestic terror threat is being ignored. Welcome, Daryl.
Thank you.
Now, Daryl, I want to start with you first because it is that second book that is the topic of this discussion, and that book is based on something you are intimately familiar with. So you're not just a career intelligence analyst, you are, but you're not just the author of these two books, which are about the rise of violent extremism in America, but you're the former head of the DHS intelligence team that tracked and helped write a report about the rise of white supremacist terrorism that was all but dismissed back in 2009, right?
That's correct. That report actually started in January of 2007 with a call from the U.S. Capitol Police, who asked us to monitor the web for any threats against then-Senator Barack Obama, who was going to announce his candidacy for president. So that's kind of the genesis of the report. And so I postulated, what if, you know, what if our first African-American, presidential candidate got elected and became president? What would that do to the threat landscape?
So that's what your team began tracking, just one call from the Capitol Police saying, hey, this senator who just happens to be black and who might just happen to be the first black president of the United States of America is running for president. What could happen was basically what you started with. So what happened after you began tracking then Senator Obama and the online activity between him announcing his candidacy and becoming elected?
Yeah, so for about a month or two, we monitored the web when he made his announcement, and we didn't see any threats. It's only when he won the Democratic nomination leading up to the 2008 election that we started seeing the threats rolling in. And so as we saw these threats coming in on the internet, we referred them to both the Capitol Police and U.S. Secret Service. By 2009, President Obama had now taken office, and that's when we started seeing a lot of these groups recruiting and becoming radicalized. And we actually saw the first two violent attacks within a week of the election.
So